there's several changes. Some on a national level involves all of medicine. I mean, technology, the electronic medical record, molecular diagnosis, personalized medicine, concierge medicine, hospital medicine. All these are relatively new on the scene, and each one requires resilience and adaptability by the faculty. At the level here, when I first inherited the department, we had a beautiful foundation put in place by Dr. Golden, and I could see that we had to build up from that. And as we did, I realized we needed to have a unifying concept. And that we came up with, we had a retreat, came up with the idea of patient-centered. So it's patient-centered care, patient-centered research, patient-centered teaching, so that these three major missions of the department would all revolve around patients. I'm totally reliant on the division directors and our vice chairs. The vice chairs look at a core mission of education, teaching, patient care that goes through all divisions. But each division is an entity to its own, and that director has to have the best content knowledge in the world. There can't be somebody who comes in that knows more, say, about rheumatology or infectious disease than they do. They've got to be a world expert. Then they've got to have personnel skills. They have to have the intellectual quotient, emotional quotient, I'm sorry, as well, to keep people positive, make sure their careers are advanced, etc. And finally, financially and business-wise, these units have to at least break even. This is a difficult job. I'm very fortunate in my career to have enjoyed working with tremendous division directors. These people are uniquely talented, and it's sort of interesting when you're not calling away to, say, Stanford or Duke or something, but rather you're calling one of your colleagues on the phone, totally confident they know as much as anybody. The community programs serve as an extension of medicine, and that we provide attendings to participate in it, but we also provide ideas. Like Dr. Oxner had the idea for, and Guerra had the ideas for, a needle exchange clinic to reduce the transmission of hepatitis and HIV and infectious disease. Think how many lives that saved. I think the importance of caring for the local community is very much noticed by the local community. If I were to go to a social event in Tampa, I don't get asked a lot about what kind of new x-ray machines we have. I don't ask a lot about, say, what are you doing with cardiac caths? But people do ask. We saw the street medicine van. What are you doing? We heard about the bridge clinic. I think these put the more better angels of our nature, as Lincoln would say, for people to see. They show the medical student as medical school. They show the medical school is not just doing well, it's also doing good. I'm fascinated by different cultures, number one. Number two, I really enjoy different cultures. Not that they're better or worse, they just have different approaches than we do. Finally, I do love to practice medicine on any number of levels. I'll certainly still be seeing patients, giving medical advice, things like that. I don't know that any doctor can stop that. I don't know what I would be. In the international realm, every country wants to be the equal of the U.S. They've got to have somebody helping them. it's not something you can do on your own. You've got to have a tour guide say, you've got to have A before B, you have B before C. I feel that our international programs have helped many, many international graduates, as well as students here, gain a different view of the world. Just this year, so far, there's at least 40 medical students going to study outside the United States. And I assure you, the practice of medicine in, say, Cambodia, places like that, rural India, are 20 to 25 years behind the U.S. But yet that student being there inspires them and shows them where they could be. At the same time, they inspire the student because they're struggling with inadequate resources and sometimes themselves don't have a good vision. The attitude of leadership, whether it's the president, the dean, the provost, is always on excellence and creativity. I have never felt for a second that people were not encouraging my career or that people were not thinking of what was best, not just for the university, but also for their fellow man in the community. I find it an inspiring place to work, and I call it work. It's really not work. It's actually a pleasure to come in and work with people and advance people's careers. But USF, I think, is unique in higher education in that we have opportunities for people to move up. Many medical schools have an established hierarchy. And if you didn't start there and your father wasn't the head of something, progress is upstream. Here, if you have quality, you get to move ahead. One thing I'm particularly proud of is a legacy of supporting parts of humanity that are often left behind. My faculty has gone out and started Tampa Bay Street Medicine. They've started the Bridge Clinic. They started the Asian Pacific Islander Clinics, the Needle Exchange Program. None of these are on anyone's agenda. They're not in the legislature. But yet they change the community we live in. That would be one huge impact that I'm proud of. The second thing I'm proud of is our extraordinary rise in teaching. We're at a stratospheric level of success in teaching. And we are a medical school. We're supposed to be teaching. So if you think, I have some of the best teachers, not just in the U.S., in the world. You can sit in a lecture and you're enthralled. And I like the commitment, finally, to absolute quality. When I look at what my faculty does, I'm never kept up at night worried that somebody made a mistake, did the wrong thing, or hurt a patient. That doesn't happen much in internal medicine. And that bit of quality is what gives us our U.S. News and National Report rankings. That bit of quality is what's resulted in unprecedented growth in patients for our Morsani College of Medicine. My final thoughts would be that I want to thank my students, my trainees, my faculty, my director, and the people in senior administration. What I am today is a product of all these people's efforts. You know, this is not my success. This is very much their success. And I want to say, thank you very much. USF has provided a career beyond my wildest dreams. I could sit and entertain you for hours with adventures I've had and things I've learned. But if you're going to pick an institution to stay with, USF is the place to stay.